Since the bushfire started in New South Wales and Queensland back in September, the bushfire smoke has become a real feature of the landscape right through the eastern seaboard and including for some of our major capital cities. And as more fires have started, we've seen the smoke become more extensive and it's now even travelling around the globe. So there's several different factors that contribute to smoke lingering in an area. One is the proximity of a location to the fire. Another is the topography around that area, which can funnel wind in a certain direction. And then the wind itself. So if you've got a light wind, then it's likely to leave the smoke lingering in an area rather than dispersing it to other parts of the country. Another meteorological factor that causes smoke to stay in an area is what's known as a temperature inversion. Normally, as you go upwards in height in the atmosphere, we have the temperature decreasing. But when we have a high pressure system near us, we have air actually descending, and that creates a little pocket of air where the temperature increases with height. And this acts like a blanket and it traps the air underneath, and in this case is trapping the smoke. Recently, Canberra and more broadly the ACT have had thick smoke persisting. And this has really been due to the proximity of the fires through New South Wales, but also more recently, smoke's been transported from Victoria and South Australian fires as well. Now, Canberra is surrounded by mountains to the east, and normally a southerly or an easterly wind would act to move out the smoke from the Canberra region. But just with given where the fires are to the east and south, that's just not happening at the moment. So we're just seeing that smoke persisting through the ACT. In Sydney, smoke haze has really become a daily feature, and it's actually the western suburbs of Sydney that have seen the worst prolonged smoke. And that's because the easterly winds have been coming in offshore and pushing smoke further west, but then the Blue Mountains to the west of Sydney have been really just trapping that smoke and not allowing it to move further inland. So again, as long as we've still got fires in the landscape, smoke is still going to continue to be a problem for Sydney and the greater Sydney area. In Victoria, the thickest smoke has been in the east of the state where the worst of the fires have been, and particularly through the valleys and the mountainous areas where at night time we see the air drain into those valleys, creating what's called a nocturnal temperature inversion, that really trapping those smoke in the valleys. But of course in Melbourne as well, easterly winds have dragged smoke from the east over Melbourne and even into western Victoria, and we're likely to see that again on Thursday with conditions really worsening as easterly winds are bringing the smoke again from East Gippsland. So until we see the southerly change move through Victoria on Friday, we're really likely to see smoke linger throughout the state. Tasmania has also seen smoke over the last few days, particularly about the north of the state, and this has really been due to the effect of two high pressure systems, one to the east and one to the west. The easterly high pressure system has been driving northerly winds down over Tasmania and bringing smoke from the Gippsland fires right across Bass Strait to the northern parts. But then the high pressure system to the west, that's been dragging southerly winds over the state. So we've really seen this convergence line between these two wind regimes, and that's been the boundary for where we've seen the smoke. It's likely on Thursday again that we'll see smoke increasing across Tasmania, but when the strong southerly change moves through on Friday, we should see that clear out and much clearer skies return to the state. So of course the question that everybody's asking is, when is the smoke going to clear? Well, obviously as long as we've got fires in the landscape and we keep seeing these peak fire weather days, we are likely to see the smoke continue to linger through parts of the country. So it really is important for people to continue to follow advice from their local authorities on how to stay safe in these smoky conditions.